of electron. So how to find out effective mass of electron? The symbol normally used, the notation normally used to show effective mass of electron is m n star. For any system, if you need to find out what is the net force acting on the system, then we can write that the net force acting on any system can be written as the external force plus the internal force. A particle, or if you will consider an electron in a free space, it behaves in a very different way if you will consider the same electron in a crystal lattice. What is the difference? What is the difference between the electron in a free state and if you will consider the same electron in a crystal lattice? Let me tell you, if you are considering the electron in free state, then the potential energy we said is zero. All its energy is kinetic. So for that, you can write F net is equal to the external force only, as there is no internal force. But if you will consider the same electron in a lattice, then you will have to take into account the internal force, because there are many positive ion force present and other electrons present in the crystal lattice, and hence the force experienced by the electron will be the external force, and plus the force that is experienced by the electron due to the positive ion force and all the other electrons present, as I told you. So here in this case, to find out exactly if I am right, as I said, for free state we need to take the external force only, and for a bound state we need to consider the external force as well as the internal force. And then if I will write mass into acceleration, and this is external plus the internal force, it is quite difficult to find out what is the exact internal force acting on that electron particularly. Because as I told you, many positive force and numerous amount of free electrons or electrons are there, you cannot exactly find out the internal force. But what we can do is, we can take the effect of this internal force on the mass of the particle, and we can take the changed mass, okay, taking into account the internal force, effect of internal force. So in that case, we can just write, I will ignore this internal force and will take the effect of internal force on the changed mass. So I can write this as, just to distinguish this mass from the rest mass, or whatever mass earlier you have taken, I'm putting this sign. And for electron, if I am considering, I will write this as L n star A. That is L star. So this is the classical approach to find out the external force, taking into consideration the effect of the internal force on the changed mass, and that changed mass we called as effective mass of electron. This is the classical approach. If I would like it in terms of quantum mechanics, or the as a consequence of Schrodinger's equation, then I can write it from quantum mechanics. We have already defined this E is equal to h bar square k square by 2m. This is exactly for free state I am writing. As we said, total energy is sum of potential energy and kinetic energy, and if I am writing this h bar square k square by 2m, which is nothing but p square by 2m, here I am ignoring the potential energy. Potential energy you have taken is a 0. So this is, I am taking for a free particle. So this can be written as h bar square k square by 2m. Then if I find the first derivative of this expression I wrote, d by dk. Let us find out this. Then I can write h bar square by 2m, 2k. We have this as h bar square k by m, which can be rewritten as h bar multiplied with h bar k divided by m. This gives us h bar. This is p, the linear momentum, and in classical approach, if I write this as mv divided by m, mm were cancelled. I can write 1 by h bar of dE by dk is equal to v. So one conclusion we got, that the first derivative of energy with respect to k is related with velocity of that particle, or here we can say velocity of the electron which is in free state. Okay, as I said, we have taken the potential energy is 0. Now if I take the second derivative from this equation itself, dE by dk, we got h bar square k by m. Then let's take the second derivative first. Okay, so I can find out d square e by dk square, so that I will obtain this is h bar square by m, and hence we can write 1 by h bar square is equal to 1 by h bar square is equal to 1, or simply I can write 1 by h bar square d square e by dk square is equal to 1 by m. So second derivative of energy with respect to k is associated with the reciprocal of the mass, or is equal to the reciprocal of the mass, which we said for a bound state, as I told you, the potential energy we have taken there is 0. But I told you, and hence I have written this as m only, which is in the absence of internal force. Potential energy is 0, so the internal force over here we have taken as 0. But if I consider the internal force, then I can write the same expression, do the same way, but I need to take the changed mass. And hence, I can write the same equation, but this notation I will change, and we like one. We write 1 by h bar square d square by dk square is equal to 1 by m. What I have done over here? The same thing, but here I consider the potential energy is not 0. There is some potential, as we said, the electron is in crystal, it is in a bound state, internal forces you need to take into account, but as I said, it is very difficult to find out the exact value of internal force. We can take the effect of internal force on the mass, and the change mass we need to consider. That's why I have given this notation m star to find for you. So this is the expression which can be written for effective mass of electron inside a crystal. Now we need to see
how this m star, or the effective mass of the electron, depends upon the energy band diagram, structure of energy band. Okay. Suppose we will consider the conduction band. As we have already discussed, the shape of the conduction band somehow like this, where the minimum energy of the conduction band is defined. Let us write the notation for the minimum conduction energy band is Vc. Okay. Then you define any electronic state which corresponds to the energy value E. For this, if you need to find out what will be the nature of the effective mass, then just write this E is a function of k square, Ec is also a function of k square, using the free particle approximation as part of this call coincides exactly with the free particle approximation. We can just assume the free particle approximation, and hence I can write any energy value over here, the function of k square, any electronic state corresponding that particular energy, and the minimum energy value can also be written as function of k square. And now if I take the energy gap for this